but we're running late.
Where are my boots?
Oh, crap. Okay, hang on. You're lucky I like you.
Okay, thank you.
I'm gonna try to finish up in here.
All right, finish up.
And then it's all yours.
I don't want to be waiting on you.
I'm James, 52 years old, all the way from Texas. Here to get this little raspberry on my lower eyelid taken off. About 2.5 years ago, I started noticing just a little pimple bump, and it's grown ever since.
It's hard and dry.
It doesn't take very much to just bump it, and it'll start bleeding.
It was bleeding on me this morning. Now it's scabbed up a little bit. I must have hit it in the night. See that scab right there?
Yeah. Oof. You're nuts.
Mm-hmm. It blocks my lower vision as it is now. So if it keeps growing, it's just going to cover my eyesight completely.
If I wasn't pestering him about it, I don't know that he would have sought treatment as urgently as we are now.
I don't want to show pain or fear and be viewed as a soft guy, so I think that produces procrastination to where you just put things off.
I honestly hope that Dr. Lee will just be able to just pop a little cyst out and say goodbye. That's what I'm hoping.
Skin is the largest organ in the body, right? Billions and billions of cells. So, of course, the more cells you have, the more opportunity you have for something to go a little awry and growths to grow. It's like a garden of growths, really. The longer we live, the more the garden grows. You can have angiomas, lipomas, acrochordon, verruca, skin cancer. You can have pyogenic granulomas,
seborrheic keratosis,
steatocystomas, trichodiscomas, trichofolliculomas. There's dilated pores. Whiners, so many different things that can occur on your skin. You watch me do these surgeries, this is just a little minutia. This is just a little sneak peek into our world of dermatology. Ooh, it looks mad.
Yeah.
Like it's hanging down a little bit. Do you mind if I take a good look here? Is it hurting you at all?
It stings a little bit, especially when I bump it real hard.
Okay. How long have you had this?
I've had this about 2.5 years.
It was actually flesh colored for the longest time, and then now, It's gotten a little angry, mad
at you, maybe because it knew you were coming around here, huh?
Yeah.
Right, you're a lucky guy, though, because you got this wonderful fiance.
She's the main reason I'm here.
Oh.
Even got this far. I wouldn't have ever done it myself.
As a dermatologist, we definitely deal with growths like this that bleed and then heal and then bleed again. That's usually a way that we describe different kinds of skin cancers. Certainly that can be concerning to people. Basal cell carcinomas, squamous cell carcinomas, and melanomas are the three most common type of skin cancers. Types of skin cancers like melanoma can spread internally and threaten your life, you know, really, because they can spread through your blood, through your lymphatic system. I'm here with James, and I really suspect that he's got a skin cancer underneath his eye. And it is really close to important structures, so I do think it's really important to do this sooner rather than later. So I think this is a basal cell carcinoma. It is a kind that, even though it's a C word, it's not life-threatening. Yeah, that's good. Unless it were to come a huge size.
Yes, ma'am.
But it is locally invasive. So it can take over your eye, it can take over, especially where it is here. So these are the things we're concerned about.
Yeah, none of that, please.
Right.
Anytime the word cancer comes in, you want to be paying attention to what she's saying.
I think I'm kind of a little bit in shock right now.
So, and the best way to remove this is a technique called Mohs surgery. We take that tissue and we slice it really thin so that I can look at it under the microscope to see whether there's any more of the skin cancer cells left. Yeah. If there is, I've made a map of how I've taken this off on you so I can go back and take a little bit more. So it's tissue sparing, meaning we're taking as little of you as possible.
Okay, great.
So I think that we should go through this process, make sure that we can get rid of this completely, certainly.
All right.
The challenging part of removing this basal cell carcinoma, or BCC, is the fact that it is so close to important structures like the eye. The skin there is very thin, and you know, you have to be able to remove something and always try to think ahead about how you're going to close this so it doesn't pull open his eye. Okay, I'll see you in a little bit.
All right, thanks again.
Wow. Well, I guess it's not just a simple pop.
All right, you guys, we're gonna bring you guys on back, okay?
I really wanna get it taken care of. Never heard of a Mohs surgery, never been to a dermatologist.
nervous.
I had to get a shot with a needle in my eye.
Nice to see you guys. What I'm gonna do first is we're gonna put some numbing in that area.
Mohs micrographic surgery is a specific technique that we use as skin preservation. We use it to remove basal cell carcinomas and squamous cell carcinomas. I numb the area first, and then I remove what I physically see and about a millimeter or so of normal tissue around it.
Let me process this, and we'll look at it under the microscope. It's gonna take a little bit. I say it's a lot of hurry up and wait.
Okay.
Okay, you did okay though, huh?
Yes, thanks, okay. Dr. Lee.
Wow.
I'm gonna look at this piece of tissue under the microscope to see whether there's still some cancer that remains.
What I do is when I look under the microscope, I'm checking to make sure I have skin edges and I can see where my markings are, like the colors of the nicks of the tissue. Now when I'm looking in the microscope, I see some positive edges and I'm gonna mark that where I see it. So we have to do another layer here.
It looks like there's still some skin cancer cells present, and this always makes me concerned, especially when we're coming up close to its structure, like his eye. There are certain areas that this can progress to, like if this affects his eyelid, then that's really an area that I would refer this to somebody else. So we might not even be able to complete the surgery if it progresses too far.
Hopefully that's it. Those flaps of skin were bigger than I expected her to take off.
Oh my God.
All right. So you're clear.
Got it.
When I look at it in the microscope, I don't see any more skin cancer cells.
Nice.
I'll go ahead, I'm gonna send this to pathology, but we got it.
Big sense of relief after she said she got it.
If I felt like I could exhale, I had been holding my breath the entire time.
You can take a look. It's gonna be funny looking and bumpy, okay?
All right, Dr. Lee.
There you go.
Nice.
After 2.5 years of dealing with this on my face, just real ecstatic to see it gone. It was just unbelievable. It wouldn't even look like I'd never had a little raspberry there.
I cannot believe how well it turned out. I'm completely shocked. This is not just a medical procedure. This is like engineering.
Now you know to see a dermatologist, right?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you very much.
And sunscreen.
Yes, and sunscreen.
Thank you.
Okay, bye.
Wow. Something completely different.
I'm happy that we got here and got this done. I feel like a new person just from 1 minute to the next.